golden mine, where the traveler's journey is done. Where the youth find a way with desire, and the pale virgin shrouded in snow.
She walked down Avenue A, waving wands of light in the gray dawn. She wore a shoulder stole woven of foxglove and heather, and a mini skirt made out of an antique Victorian lampshade. She worked at the Digger Free Store. She stood up for social justice in the tear gas of Chicago. She could melt giant hippie moray candles with her aura. Her name was Sherry Bindle. Now, of course, she's the dean of the Yale Medical School. But then she was Sherry Bindle, Snow Gullet.
Organized the commune on the Avenue.
when he heard it in 1966, enabled Philip Roth to make $4.5 million off of Portnoy's complaint.
Woke up this morning with my sweetheart in my hand. My head was empty, my heart was full of sand. I got them jack-off-a-loo.
Next, the noble anarcho-Hasidic chant from 1967 that got disc jockeys fired all across the United States.
Slavery.
radio to a nightingale. Sitting beneath a plum tree one spring day, out on Hampstead Heath. There's nothing sadder than a broken love, like poor John Keats and Fanny Braun. Ooh. I hope we'll find a measure of peace in the golden barred retirement home. I'll be there in a golden wheelchair, wheeling with you, my love. And remember all the poems in the morning mail. And you never heard a voice say fail. Oh, they say it's not what you throw in the flames, but what you can save. A snort of fame and a bottle of dream, a spatula of ink and blood in the sink. Oh, 60-year rain will wash away the pain. So if we had a better word to make a better world, we'd probably utter it over and over, my love, above the trembling bed. And no more slaves.
Okay, sing along with us at the end. At the end of this next song, we want you to shout out your favorite line of philosophy or poetry, religious maxim, apothegm, your phone number, whatever moves you to shout that means a lot to you. And this is one of the more important works since Wittgenstein, Sartre, Bertrand Russell, and George Bush.
Monday nothing and Tuesday nothing, Wednesday and Thursday nothing, Friday for a change and a little more nothing, reverently nothing, Roosevelt take nothing, Jerome and Buddy nothing, Eisenhower, Dolphy, nothing. Johnson, Nixon, humongous pricks, and Ronnie, Warstar, nothing. And Karl Marx, nothing. Trotsky.
money, oh, nothing. Marriage is nothing. Ooh. Make divorce something. Well, having kids is nothing. They all grow up and leave you anyway. Bosses and daughters of nothing.
Let's hear it. Let's go. In perfect time of the rosy-headed woodpecker high on the thick shag bark like a clave player with a complicated fill at a Prez Prado gig in 1948. The wind struck the azalea flower and the black-winged butterfly licking nectar clung flutteringly thereon as the bow dipped down.
Oh, she's hanging gently.
in the rain. Oh yeah. Ooh, nectar. Licking nectar in the wind. Oh yeah. Nectar. Licking nectar in the wind. Oh yeah.
Tent. And there was plenty of what was known as orange sunshine at the festival, and there was purple haze, and there was green sunshine. There was also a hideous substance known as no sunshine. And that morning, a young man known as Bad Vibes Bill dumped a giant glop of no sunshine into a vat of oatmeal. And it sank hissing and hideous to the bottom, where it looked like a pulsating blob of frog eggs. And not long thereafter, a young man from New York City took his morning oatmeal, and soon he stumbled into the tent known as Big Pink with wildly dilating eyes. And as we shall see, he was the first person in the history of Western civilization to have, instead of a flashback, a flash forward. sunshine. It's a freak out. Tuli. This is the Archangel Smegoni. Tuli. Life has many things in store for you. You know that actor? That slow learner who's the governor of the state of California? Someday he'll be president of all the United States. Truly. And the war in Vietnam? The angels have seen that you've been in a lot of demonstrations in 1969. Do you know how long the war is going to last? For another 6 years, Tuli. And are you prepared for a weird autoimmune disease? Do you know that when you, Tuli Kupferberg, go to a dentist in 1989, the dentist will be entirely wrapped in surgical gloves, gauze, and saran wrap? And Tuli, do you know that someday, you know that apartment you're paying $23 a month for on East 10th Street? They're gonna get $2,000 a month for it in only 20 years. And have you heard about a guy named George Bush? You haven't. This geek is going to be president, Tuli. President of the United States.
be the Indian paint. Together we'll run in the Woodstock
together we'll run in the drumhead.